Hello, beautiful Aquarius. Welcome to your Life Path and Abundance reading. Let's jump in and see what Spirit is recommending. We have four messages here. Spirit of gratitude. Well, the attitude of gratitude will always get you where you want to go much more quickly than vinegar. So we see the Diamond Dreamer, material wealth, and true prosperity. Wow. Okay. So that's a powerful reading for you, Aquarius. Many of you have been working on a dream, and it looks as though this is the month that it may actualize in the earthly plane, on the earthly plane. Spirit is asking you to let go and let Spirit bring you an abundance of beautiful jeweled, you know, like jewels of value in your life. Stay connected to Spirit, because what we're seeing here is that what you will actually receive will be much grander than anything you can imagine as an earthling. All right, let's see. We have the Dreaming. We have two cards here. Look at this. Isn't this interesting? The Diamond Dreamer and the Dreaming. So it does suggest that you jot down your dreams, you follow your heart, you follow your bliss into your future. All right, so we do have Mercury retrograde as of today. I'm doing this on the 27th. So please take note. Remember that Mercury retrograde is not the end of the world, although it sometimes feels like it. It is a great time for taking a break, reassessing, reviewing and renewing things like your subscriptions, you know, cutting on your budget, you know, really looking at revisions, editing what you've already done. So what we see here is that we also have a time when you are very likely to hear from people from the past. And it is also a time, I really love to say this, anybody who has been lost to you, sometimes I have been consulted about lost children. I don't really do that work specifically, but we find that during Mercury retrograde, anyone who gets lost or goes missing tends to be found in good condition in terms of their health and their well-being. So I just want to throw that out there for you, Aquarius. What we see in your first house of what you're bringing in, you're learning something new. You're nurturing some knowledge and some expertise that you've been developing. It looks as though you're going to the next level in your career, and you're very much being careful with your thoughts, your feelings, and your intentions for yourself. You're taking good care of yourself. You look better than you've looked in many years, health-wise, I feel, because you are really minding the store in terms of what you are taking in terms of stress, in terms of your relationships with others, as well as just nutritionally speaking. And I have a rascal of a dog down here. Miss Rose, come here. Come here. I don't want you barking during the reading. All right, so Miss Rose has joined me in the chair. We have, look at this, I like this. Right now, it appears that you are not focused on one particular partner. Even if you have a partner, you feel like your partner is your best friend. It doesn't really take any action from you. I'm seeing there's not a lot of activity right there in terms of being able to really celebrate and go out and have the fun that you want. But it's okay. It's self-imposed restriction. No worries. When we look at your money house, we look at a situation in which a possible romantic interest may have triggered you in some way. We see the Five of Swords. Somebody has treated you a little bit unfairly here in a romantic matter, in a financial matter. So it does speak to the fact that there could be some outstanding conflict in regard to a former lover, a current lover, with some sort of disagreement. We have the Five of Swords twice. So there does seem to be an argument about some sort of money or some sort of money situation. Now we see you, when we look at other people's money, the eighth house that you're living through right now or living within, is that you don't feel you have a lot of support from other people. However, you're powering through. So even though you might be at a low point in your ability to, say, get a loan or get a new credit card, or that you don't really have a lot of resources or you don't have access to another person's resources, you're doing very well on your own. The Six of Wands says that you are most likely likely being very good at paying down debts and really having a big victory in terms of your standing, credit worthiness, and so forth. So it's really a big, it's a powerful, powerful time in your life for being able to really do what you want in the future. When we look at the energy of your third house of your local neighborhood, it looks as though you're very happy. You look very content. You feel very much as though you are paying, you know, a pretty penny probably for the place that you live, but the truth be told, you really wouldn't want to be somewhere else. It also shows that you're getting a lot of amenities. It's a neighborhood that it's a very nice, very, very nice neighborhood. I think very oriented to community projects and activities. And it looks as though you could actually earn some money in regard to that. If you put yourself out there for new business or clients or whatever, it looks as though you would do very well. When we look at your ninth house of international travel, higher education, some of you may have achieved a very high status in your work career, but may be really feeling as though it's a never-ending story when it comes to student debt, you know, that kind of energy. When we see the Hermit card, I sort of get that vibe for you. You know, this will resonate with everybody differently, but we see at least a lack of travel. You do have great mastery in some area to do with law or broadcasting. It looks as though right now, you're not where you want to be in terms of your career and long-range plans, your hopes and dreams, but you're building. You know, you're building very steadily with this Eight of Coins energy. When we look at your home front, we see that there seems to be almost like an authority figure, whether it's a landlord, you know, it looks like there's some sort of changes in the environment in which you live. Your career, though, looks absolutely outstanding. So your career looks as though you are manifesting, you are able to defend yourself, you're able to rise to the top. And with this emperor here, I mean, this emperor is a powerhouse. So you're doing very well for yourself, even if there are areas of your life that you'd like to improve in, which it's normal, right? We always want to improve. You are about to have a new romance. It looks like you could be dating two different people, but you look as though sometime in the month of October, you make a decision and you decide to go with one particular relationship. But you have options, you know. It looks like you are juggling more than one romantic interest. When it comes to your friendships and having a chance to spend time with other people, we're seeing that you're missing that. It looks as though you would like to be a lot more assertive about, you know, having some fun, getting together. There's a sense of loneliness or sadness there, and possibly even a friend in which there were words spoken with that Knight of Swords energy. Words harshly or quickly spoken could cause regret. When we look at your health, your everyday life, your, you know, day in and day out, you're feeling a little bit like, I'm kind of bored. You know, this is a card of saying, where's my love? Where are all of my dreams? But you really are appreciative of what you have. It looks like you have a very good family life and, you know, people around you that you've known for many years. But you want something new. I'm really seeing that you want something new. So, you know, it's good energy overall. It's just, I think we're on lockdown again, or, you know, we're in some version of that. And that's how I see it. When we look at what is going on behind the scenes, it looks like somebody may offer you, may make a rather significant offer to you that will be quite secretive. We see the Ace of Coins, which is, it can be an offer in love, but it also can be an offer in any kind of partnership to level up. We're seeing somebody of sort of international acclaim or fame, or local acclaim or fame, is making a very private offer to you for a new job or a new beginning. But when we get the One of Coin with the Nine of Coin, I would say that for many of you, you're going to take that. That puts you in pre-Empress mode, and it is setting you up for a lot of success. And we have your hopes and dreams coming true. So it's a fantastic month for you. I think the only thing that you're dealing with is like the mundane, irritating facts of life, you know. But if you stay focused on your dreams, if you stay focused on your gratitude, Spirit is telling you, we're going to give you more than you can imagine, more than you could even think about, even more than you know about, and material wealth and true prosperity. So that's what we have for you there. I'm going to jump into your love reading. Aquarius, your love life, what's going on here? I'm looking at this and we see that in the recent past, there is the Ten of Wands. The overall energy is leaving something behind that was a heavy burden, something that you love or someone that you loved very much. So it does speak to the fact that right now you're not feeling particularly peppy. So, or really optimistic even. I think that you're struggling a bit here. We get the energy in the recent past between you and a love interest of a collapse. The tower has come down. Somebody that you thought you would have a future with. The tower is no foundation. The foundation has to be rebuilt in a love relationship. Right now, it looks as though you're not speaking to somebody, but it does look like the energy is building here for someone to come in and speak with you. The Chariot card is somebody coming towards you, is what I have, Aquarius. In terms of your love interest and how they view or the person, I will say this. This can be a love reading with anybody. It can be a friend. It can be a lover. But it can be anybody that you're fond of. But take it as it resonates. But we do have the Chariot card. We have two Chariot cards here back to back. So your person is coming in towards you. It looks as though they would like to reinvent the magic between the two of you. They're trying to manifest some activity from you. They could be calling you and just saying, Aquarius, let's go have some fun. And you might be saying no temporarily. How they view you. They view you as someone who is holding back, who's looking for a victory in love, that you will hold back until you get what you actually would like to have. In their heart space about this relationship, this person has remorse and regret. They're also holding back. Self-imposed restriction is here twice. So it looks as though you're in a no contact situation currently. The friendship is how your person sees the two of you moving forward. We get the energy of the Knight of Pentacles moving slowly out of a difficult situation. because we're going from the Tower and the Emperor, sort of my way or the highway energy, to let's work things out. Let's really make this work. Let's be practical. Let's really honor our friendship and our deep connection with each other is how your person is thinking about this. The truth of the matter is that both of you want to hold on to the good feelings of love that you have. Both of you, the truth be told, are, you know, you're juggling that you really fought about some things that weren't very significant, but both of you are really holding on to the idea that maybe this can be reinvented, reinvigorated, renewed. Mercury retrograde is a time that happens frequently. Spirit is saying that sleepless nights, you really need to face what you invested with this person. That right now that your sleepless nights are really caused by your fear that you invested more than you should. And what we're really seeing here is Spirit's trying to say, you can't have a relationship without being invested. So stop worrying, don't fuss. But we see a lot of pain here. Look at right through the heart of the reading, Aquarius. So please make sure, you know, if you'd be so kind to leave comments below. But this looks like a very tough situation in which a long-term relationship or knowing somebody for a long time has really caved. You know, it's almost like beneath your feet, something just fell apart. The building shifted and fell. We get the energy of the outcome at this time is the Five of Swords. There's an ongoing conflict. It looks as though you're cool, calm, and collected. You've been through storms before and you are okay, you know, okay enough. You're not happy with this situation. But let's get a couple more clarifiers here for you, Aquarius. Right now, it just looks like you're taking life a day at a time. You're not getting ahead of yourself, and you're staying focused on career is what I'm seeing, which is a good place. It's helping heal your heart. But you look as though you've been through a rough time a bit here with a lover, with a friend, or maybe with multiple people. Yeah, the Eight of Cups really speaks to the fact that you're going to leave behind stress. You're going to leave behind something else that's, you know, caused unhappiness. And your feeling is very much that it wasn't your fault, that things fell apart, that the person you were dealing with had a lot of, not insincere energy, but very much, you know, they always planned on being a temporary part of your life. They didn't plan on staying around. They care about you very deeply, but this, you know, facing the fact that this person was never really doing anything other than enjoying very wonderfully their time with you. But Knight of Wands is a card that can be player energy, but it also speaks to the fact that this knight is on his way to a war and he's going to have fun along the way. And it's really for an afternoon, a night, a weekend, but it's not forever. So Aquarius, I'm sorry that wasn't a very happy love reading for you, but I feel as though you're coming through this beautifully with some new energy coming in and somebody coming back to give you an apology. That's what it looks like. So let me know. Take care. Thank you. Bye-bye.